Safe.
Not in front of his widow. How you holding up, Carmen?
You all set up for breakfast?
even though he was my very own set flesh and set blood, he was as cold to me as he was to my mother.
Breakfast is gonna be cold if you don't eat now, folks.
Hey, well, at least we're all in the clear. We're all on the stage, but all time Sydney got the old keep ho.
Well, actually, the coroner says Bernstein was struck on the head before he died. Someone knocked him out backstage before he rehearsed George's number, then wrapped a counterweight rope around his neck, knowing that when the curtain closed, it would finish the job if he wasn't already dead. Bernstein recovered consciousness just in time to die. So you see, he could have been killed by any person with access to this stage, including you, Jolene.
What does that mean?
We found a copy of Variety with the words cut out of it in the stage manager's office. Your office.
Chris and Lucy will have keys as well.
Well, then it seems you three are my first official murder suspects.
Well, it's an honor just to be nominated.
But everybody is still under suspicion. I found this little black book in Bernstein's breast pocket. Does it look familiar? Each page has a notation written of a cast member. Obviously, the reason why each of you are being blackmailed.
No! Minnie! No! I wasn't being blackmailed!
But also meaning... I just found more death threats.
Oh gosh. Dear Sydney, end of the show or it's the end of you.
Oh no! Sid Bernstein died for nothing! He told me he was gonna close the show!
When did he tell you that?
In his office. Someone right that minute had changed his mind about keeping Robinhood open. He even gave me back the last check I wrote him.
Well, you can give it back to me. I am not closing this show. Come on, Lucille. Let's put this check in a safe place.
Felt very safe in my pocket. What's the matter?
Well, it's been bothering me since yesterday. I mean, why is it that Bobby...
What?
I mean, of all people on the stage...
All right, Lieutenant. Spit it out.
You ought to be in the Fort Henderson Square Dance number.
Beg pardon?
You'd stop the show. Hey, after all, wouldn't Robin Hood go to the big picnic disguised at Al Modell?
You know what? He's got a point. It makes sense.
And Daryl Hardy of the Boston Globe loved Bobby's dancing.
Bobby, do you think you can improvise a short turn in time for tonight?
Well, sure, but I don't know if I can make the costume change for the next scene.
Oh, for gosh sakes, Bobby. It's just losing a bandana and putting on a mask. Would it kill you to try?
Well, time it up now. Jolene, the Fort Henderson Square Dance number.
The Fort Henderson Square Dance number.
Now we are getting somewhere. Aaron, for the love of Mike, we have got to have the rewrite you promised for In the Same Boat.
I already did it.
Without me?
Yeah, honey, we rehearsed it last night where we were getting fitted.
To be honest, I think it turned out pretty well.
Well, can we hear a bit of it?
Sure. I've changed it to Rob Hood and his men heading up the mighty Colorado. You know, a real He-Man approach. Sasha, a quick chorus of In the Same Boat.
Randy, Harv, help me out here.
If you just heard it last night, what's the orchestra playing?
I wrote a brand new melody to fit the old orchestra parts.
I think we've got it now.
I'm doing the best that I can.
Excuse me, everyone! I just had a thought.
Oh, how long we've waited for this day.
Okay. If we're adding Bobby to the Kansas Line number, it so happens he and I have been working on a dance routine that's perfect for my St. Louis Soup character. And him.
It's sort of a pas de deux.
Pas de deux for two. I'd be the the wicked city woman who vamped the handsome cowboy.
Well, Bobby, it would save us a lot of time if it's ready to go.
We've only talked it through.
I'm ready!
Carmen, Bambi's the spawn of your loins. What do you think?
Normally, I'd say over my dead body, but I don't want to give anybody any ideas, so... Sure!
Let her take a shot at it.
Come on, we better go to the cast.
Aaron, I thought you were going to write us a better version of it the same boat.
We just played it. Did you not hear it?
I did. Aaron! I thought you were going to write us a better version of In the Same Boat.
I'm putting In the Same Boat into dry dock for the time being.
Aaron, please come back when you have a better song.
Oh, thank you for the chance, Mother.
It's called giving you enough rope to hang yourself, Elaine. Maybe not my best choice of words.
You always make fun of me in front of other people.
Perhaps I should leave.
No. You have dreams of being in the theater too, Choppy. You should hear this. Elaine, as a Broadway producer, there's something much more important to me than you getting a star turn. What? Me turning a profit. I've never been known as one of those stupid clocks.
Smorky, honey, mistake.
Sweetie, the only thing that you could arouse is suspicion.
Ah! The company's ready to run squirts.
Oh, joy beyond my wildest dreams. Yeah. And, Carmen, how many hours do we have left until we're re-reviewed by...
Dale Grady, the Boston Globe.
Grady? You're not what I expected, but then again, I've never actually seen a picture of you.
Complete anonymity is a critic's best tool.
Well, I suppose I shouldn't bite the hand that slaps me, but it's unethical to review our rehearsal.
You forget I report on Theater for the Globe as well as review it. Your show is news, and I'm setting aside my customary professional distance to interview members of your company down in the green room with your permission. Miss Bernstein? No.
Free publicity, Carmen. Poor Sidney would have died to get this much press. And he did. The green room is yours, Grady.
All right, then. The Fort Henderson Square Dance number, Bambi auditioning a new section with Bobby.
Oh, this I have got to see.
Keep all of your fingers crossed.
So follow us now as we follow the yellow brick road down the wrong direction, all the way to Kansas land. Sasha, yee-haw.
Okay, so here's where the shot entered and exited. It grazed Bobby, but may have been intended for you. Randy, why aren't you wounded?
I am. Deep down.
You can ask him why.
Well, are you usually standing here at this point in the number? No, when Bobby went to jump, I moved here to give him some room.
Well, then most likely you weren't the target either. So, step on its path. The bullet may have been intended for you. Nikki, were you standing here about to be shot?
I'm not sure. Is that important?
Well, if you were, then you couldn't very well have fired the shot at yourself, and I could throw you out as the killer.
You hadn't ruled me out already, Lieutenant?
Just a minute. Bobby, you're holding that handkerchief against your left arm.
Well, it's bleeding.
Really? But that's impossible if the shot came from out there. You believe it with your left side to the audience, so it's impossible for it to have hit your left arm. Guys, wasn't the skull and crossbones facing the audience?
I guess I may have set it up wrong.
Yes, so exactly the opposite. The bullet came from behind the upstage guard tower, through the barrel, grazed Bobby at the end of his leap, on its way to you.
Me?
Yes, and here's the bullet.
But that would mean that the shot was fired—
by someone on this stage or behind the scenery.
What?
Those of you who were offstage, were you with anyone?
No.
Well, then the only people who couldn't defy the shot were Carmen and Sasha because they're both downstage. Oh, hey, don't you think Bobby should do his dance, like, much further downstage?
I was planning on having the same idea.
Well, I'm afraid we'll have to search everybody for a gun.
There won't be any need for that! She did it!
She did it, that Nikki's freaking sick!
Please stop that. That was fun. Nikki, what are you doing with that?
Sorry, a stage manager is equal parts psychiatrist, mother hen, and father confessor. What anyone in this cast shares with me, I consider privileged information. Besides, what I know, I don't think you wanna.
Oh, Georgia, there you are.
Aaron, good. I've been meaning to talk to the three of you about Bernstein's little black book of blackmail. See, he had notations about every cast member with only three noteworthy exceptions. You, you, and you. Going off this book, Bernstein had nothing on you, yet the production budget says you're getting the same raw deal as everyone else. Why are you toiling for pennies when you could be getting paid so much better elsewhere? So no one has anything to say?
Well, can you blame us? If I recall, one of those death threats said, make another sound and you'll end up underground.
Yes, I know. But I never read that particular death threat out loud.
What?
Nikki and the late Miss Jessica Cranshaw were the only cast members who saw it, other than the person who sent it, of course.
Well, then I guess Nikki must have told me.
I told her not to tell anyone.
Frank, I did! I said that I wouldn't. I promised I didn't.
Then I'm very sorry, but you'll have to come with me.
Wait a second.
Nikki, would you be able to go on tonight?
Oh, now I get it. You just want to give a little boost to your sweetheart's career.
My relationship with Nikki Harris is nothing more than police investigator and possible suspect.
No, it's not.
It's not?
I really like you, Frank.
Oh, buddy.
So it's reciprocal?
Yes, it is.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Arresting me for murder?
Oh, yes! It makes perfect sense. Jessica Cranshaw's death. Please don't forget what we were saying. It makes perfect sense. Jessica Cranshaw's death gave you the chance to tour on Broadway. And when Sid Burton decided to close the show in Boston, it kept your chance alive. I'm very sorry, but you'll have to come with me.
Wait a second! Lieutenant, I'm who you want.
You're confessing to the murders, Mr. Fox?
You heard what I said.
That's not a simple thing to retract.
Think about what you're doing.
I have. Georgia, this is a great thing that's happening in your life. I'm not important now.
Very noble, but yet you're dead set against Georgia getting this role.
No. I just said that because I knew if she took the role, she wouldn't have time to write with me, to be with me. That's how Sydney got me to work for nothing. Stuck out of town together, huddled over a piano each night. Who knows what might have happened?
But that's how Sydney got me to work for the show. Aaron, I wanted the same thing.
You did?
I do.
But you and Bobby.
No, forget that.
I don't understand.
I didn't want you to, not until I knew how you really felt. You were just so preoccupied as ever with your music.
Our music was the one place you and I were still together.
Aaron, you said our songs.
Our songs? Our life? What was I thinking when I let you slip away? Oh, yeah. I was thinking of me. Only of me. What was I thinking? Spending each moment of each waking day thinking of me. Shutting you out.
Sometimes.
Making you wait.
Sometimes.
Too self-involved to say that I do need you.
Partner. nicely.
Oh, and what a treat to share a scene with you, and a fair exchange. You got Aaron to show him your cards, and I got the reason to why you both came on board with this show.
You and Georgia staged all of that?
Yes, it was her idea. A good one, I thought. And you've been playing a part too, haven't you, Bobby?
I plead guilty to playing Georgia's devoted lover.
When we started rehearsal, I asked Bobby if he would pretend we were involved again, to stir up something in Aaron, anything.
Good job.
And, oh, thank you, Bobby. I'm so very grateful.
Hey, just a reminder, you're still suspects. Wait, Bobby, I might have gotten the reason to why Aaron and Georgia came on with the show, but what's yours?
I always wanted to give the performance of a lifetime.
Fooling Aaron by acting as if you're in love with Georgia?
No, fooling Georgia that I was acting. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for her.
Except commit murder, of course.
Even that, if she asked me to.
Frank, why does love make people feel so bad? The public should be warned that Cupid is armed and dangerous.
Well, if it were up to me, I think Roman should be left strictly in the hands of the police.
Well, if you mean the present company, I'd vote yes to that proposition.
Oh, Miss Harris.
Please call me Frank. I mean, please call me Frank.
May I be bold?
I already know.
I never believed in that some enchanted evening thing until now. The first time I saw you, there was a blue wash on the stage, and the heat with a pink special, it was
just like a musical, huh, Frank?
Yes. Nikki, I thought to myself. Oh, I thought to myself.
You and I, we could be a tough act to follow. Around any pair, anywhere.
exact same time. In your fantasy, Margie Gower champion. Which one was I?
Gower.
Me too, and the song we were singing.
Would make for a great opening number.
More like a finale. Would you like to go out?
You won't let me.
I keep forgetting. And I can't make any exceptions, even though you are exceptional.
Oh, Frank, from the moment I first shook your hand.
Shook your hand.
What?
Shook your hand. Nikki, I think it's time you told me what Sid Bernstein had on you.
Nothing, really. Unlike the rest of the cast, I want to be in this show. Well, I've gotten great reviews here in Boston, and this is the best chance I've ever had at Broadway.
Jolene had hinted that a woman in the cast had used some personal connection to advance her career, and that I wouldn't like knowing who it was. Did she mean you?
Oh, every show is filled with gossip.
That wasn't a no, Nikki. Who is it?
I made a promise to someone I wouldn't talk about it. I don't break promises.
In Bernstein's black book, with the coded memos of each person's secrets, alongside your name, he wrote a great big zero.
I'm glad.
Or maybe it was an O.
Lucille, the sandwich you ordered is here. Nikki, for crying out loud, you have to get into your costume.
Sorry.
Folks, 5 minutes, and we're back on stage to learn and block yet another brand new version of In the Same Boat.
Tell me what you know about Nikki Harris.
Your voice down, Lieutenant.
If she told you something, I'd have to know.
In what capacity are you asking me that question? Office alarm, jealous boyfriend. Can what I say be held against me, or will you hold it against me if I don't say what you want to hear?
I hadn't finished placing the cast, and I'm not done with you.
Ben, bring in the storm drop, will you? Deck it. Nice and easy. I'm right underneath it. Whatever you're playing, it's not from the score of this show.
Come here, my sweetheart. Come here.
Who's that?
Don't be afraid, I won't hurt you.
Look, this is no time to joke. We've had two people die.
Oh, sorry, dear. Didn't mean to frighten you. Trying to catch poor Ophelia here. Silly little cat chased a mouse into the orchestra pit and got stuck amid the percussion instruments. I'll go put her in a basket behind the stage.
I'm set here, Ben. Take 5. Q59. Drop in planet Earth. Gotta wait for our genius director. Did you, Ophelia? Come here, kitchen. Come here. Don't be afraid. Oh, that's funny. I thought you were... Look, if you're worried about what I know about you and...
until I figure out her dying message.
Dying message?
Jolene had only seconds to live. Couldn't write, couldn't speak. Her blood stains on the stage show us she dragged herself to get her call book and ripped out a page on which she'd written, drop in planet Earth.
Well, drop in is simply the term we use for lowering scenery from up here, the flies.
Exactly. Mountain drops in, skyline drops in.
Mary Martin drops in.
Oh, there's a drop in of the earth at the end of In the Same Boat.
There will never be an end to In the Same Boat. Listen to them, they're rehearsing a new version now. New orchestra piece, third new melody, collect the entire series.
Wait a second, that's it, of course, I've solved it. We've got to get down here, fast.
Retreat after me.
I'll be along.
Okay, be careful. The killer may realize you're onto him.
I'm up here, I might as well check what's written on the side of this drop. Planet Earth. Nikki? Gosh, isn't it incredible how you can be totally stunned by something until it finally hits you?
Better than any of the other ones.
This was Chalky's big idea. Where the heck did he get to?
Yeah, something's not right.
Especially with this song.
I'll tell you what's not right. Us singing our merry little heads off when Jolene got killed just a couple of hours ago.
Jolene, Jessica, Sydney, all murdered on this stage. Which one of us is next?
Just off stage, come on!
Okay, let's go. Wait, no, let's not go. Let's not go.
Sorry.
He must have fallen down when we were coming down from the flies. What the heck were you doing all the way up there?
I'm asking myself the same question. Nikki, did you see anything up there?
I don't know. It was so dark. I suppose I could have accidentally unhitched a rope or something.
That was no accident. But it can wait because I think I've solved it. Now, I can't believe it took me so long to figure out. Let's see. Darn it! I just forgot I can't read music. Never mind, Eric. Basic logic tells me that you wrote all three songs in the same boat to fit the same orchestra part, right?
Right.
So if they all fit the same orchestra part, they must all fit with each other. That's what gives this song the kick in the dairy we've been eating. The whole company singing all three songs at once. It'll make Fugue for Tin Horn sound like Prairie Shaka.
Wait, what about the murders?
Would you forget about the murders for 1 second?
But, Sam, you got it. You solved it.
Solved how to salvage this show. Now, I'll run this now. Jolene, bring in the set.
She is dead.
Yeah, I keep forgetting. Well, I want to run this from the top. Let's bring the river. Let's have Robin Hood and the ladies trying to get to the courthouse in Wichita before the farmers lose their land. Is everybody on board with that one?
Aye, aye, Captain.
That would be Lieutenant to you.
Right.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready. It's just Georgia at the top.
In the same boat, on the same sea, shaking inside as the tide keeps rising. Nary a ship, nary a sail, nary a soul on the whole horizon.
Kick to the 3 pound cabin of the rapids.
Chewing our nails, praying that whales aren't allowed to eat.
Choffy.
I agree. But what about the killer?
Well, I'm sure the clue must be in the note that Jolene left us. Drop in planet Earth. The world on a stage, the Earth is a stage.
All the world's a stage? Shakespeare?
Shakespeare. These are actors. We're all spirits and are melted into air. That's what Jolene meant, Chris!
I did it!
No,
I'm sorry. I always take credit for everything.
What did you want?
I was on this right before Jessica dropped.
The company bows? That's the last thing we need to be
realized. You think I don't know that? Please.
All right, company places for company bows.
Wait, Nikki. I know a way to finish this up fast, but it would include putting you at some risk.
Frank, you do what you have to do.
Folks, I have a little announcement. Nikki and I just got engaged. Yes, she was leading the show at the end of its Boston run to create the role of Mrs. Lieutenant Frank Choffy.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Thank you. Now, I want to run this now. Oh, Lucille, Aaron, Carmen, you said you were watching from the back that night. Watch for me, see if you notice anything different. Sasha, go.
Plastic flowers to Jessica.
She demanded a bouquet at every performance. She also wanted us to play the Star Spangled Banner to guarantee her a standing ovation.
Yeah, I'd come down the aisle and hand them up to Jessica.
Okay, so you put on a tuxedo, come down the aisle with the flowers and hand them up to Jessica. And what would she be doing?
Well, she'd be singing.
And did anyone notice anything, different opening night?
Lieutenant, I think when she went to go take the flowers, she moved her hands to her mouth like she was covering a yawn.
Oh, or like something just struck her throat?
Well, when you put it like that, yeah, I saw that too. It happened right after she took the second bouquet.
Wait, the second bouquet?
Well, yes, Jessica had two bouquets on opening night.
Oh, yeah.
One of them was from Harv on this side, and the other one was from someone standing right here in this aisle. He was wearing a tuxedo, but the flowers in his face.
Yeah, I saw him too. Except I just figured that Carmen had hired an extra hand for opening night.
Just to boost Jessica's ego? Not a chance.
Well, maybe somebody genuinely liked Jessica's performance.
No, I think we can pull that one out.
Okay, so that's it. The killer knew about the bouquet, and on opening night, came down the aisle with flowers of his own, which hit his face and something as simple as a pellet gun. He aimed the flowers at point-blank range at Jessica's mouth and fired. And that's how your star was murdered in front of you and your audience.
But that means we're all in the clear.
No, not everyone was on the stage at that moment. Mr. Belling, where were you?
Taking a walk alone, as you darn well know.
Aaron, you said you were watching from the back?
Yes, and like every other man in the audience on opening night, I was wearing a tuxedo.
And I'll swear I was with him the entire time, Lieutenant.
I'm sure you will. Oh, Lucille?
I was sitting in the back room with Carmen. I'm pretty sure she would have noticed if I had walked up here and given someone flowers.
That's right.
That's so very right. One person alone had both perfect opportunity and a powerful motive. Choffy!
Somebody hit me.
Bobby! But if that's Bobby, who is this?
Your devoted admirer, Nikki, determined to bring down the curtain on Robin Hood, because he knew that if you went to Broadway, you'd forever leave a sphere of influence. A sphere represented by the circle next to your name in Bernstein's book. A sphere which was the clue that Jolene left us. Drop in planet Earth, or as Shakespeare called it, the great globe itself.
And the Boston Globe didn't see you pick them!
Careful, Joffy! Or no one will ever want to see your face again!
You see, Daryl?
Frank, I swear I didn't know!
But you did know, didn't you, Daryl? You shunned publicity. Your picture has never been published. Yet on opening night, she walked right up to you and tried to shake your hand for the compliments you gave her.
I asked her not to tell anyone we knew each other so I could praise and claim her in my reviews.
But it was only as a friend giving me advice. There was never anything more than that.
It was more than that to me, Nikki. I needed you to stay here where I could hail and guide you. But this infernal musical was going to Broadway no matter what I wrote about it. That's what Sid Bernstein said.
But watching the show in previews, you saw how to guarantee that Jessica Crane's show would never go to Broadway. As a critic on opening night, you could rush from your seat after the finale, fetch a bouquet hidden in the lobby, and run right down the aisle as the ultimate showstopper.
Yes, and I tried to shoot Carmen and sandbag you. The same way I posted closing notices for Jessica and Jolene. An imperfect performance on my part, but one learns from their mistakes. Right, Nikki?
Daryl, I see you right out of guns. How far from this theater do you think you can get without one?
You're right. Set your own gun down for me.
Wait!
Now!
Fine, just don't hurt her.
Get back.
Daryl, I'm gonna take Nikki away from you now.
You already have.
Frank, don't!
You take one step and you're dead. Fine, you're dead.
In situations like this, I would take the bullets out of that gun and put them into this one. Nikki, come here. Mr. Grady, you are under arrest.
My life get any worse?
You have the right to an attorney. Anything you say can or will be used against you in a court of law. Well, folks, since you're all witnesses to Mr. Grady's confession, I'll need all of you to head down to the green room for a brief statement. And then you will only have a few hours before our new opening night. Sasha, play them off, will you? Take them, O'Farrell. Dream of a new finale for the show.
And I'm sure we'll be singing a completely different number, if you think that we should. Oh, and bravo, the great detective.
Bravo, the great director.
Frank, I didn't have a clue about Daryl Grady.
I had more than one, and it still took me forever to figure out.
So, now that the mystery is solved, is our engagement over?
Let's discuss that after tonight's show. There's this coffee shop on which I'm on very good terms with the management.
Frank, we have a date. We are excused, Inspector General.
Fine, Sasha. Just for Danya.
Great work, Chaffee. Hey. You put life into a show that was dying, and now they'll put Grady away for life.
Well, I had lots of help, especially from you.
Me?
You and your daughter. I told her how her number changed my life. She was great.
Better than great.
Of course. Finally to hear you say it. You know, you and me as flim-flam as everybody else until I saw how really great she was and turned to see the pride on your face as you watched her. Listen, you tell everyone it's a business, but I found you out, Carmen. You were the stage mother of all time. You married Sid Bernstein, put up with all of his shady deals and affairs just to put your daughter onto the Broadway stage. But so that no one can accuse her of getting there on your coattails, you always belittle her talent in public, even if she hates you for it.
You can't let her know. I want her to think she got it all on her own.
You're amazing.
But how did knowing that help you catch Grady?
Oh, it
didn't. I just explained why you killed your husband.
What? Grady killed my husband.
No, Grady killed Jessica and Jolene and tried to kill you because he wanted the show closed, but that's exactly what Cindy was going to do.
Well, then he was killed by someone he was blackmailing.
No, if that was the case, they would have taken the black book with them. He must have told you he was closing the show.
He didn't tell me he was closing the show.
He told Lucille. Why would he tell you you were his partner?
Because the partnership was over! He had himself a conniving little ingenue on Sutton Place, and I was out on the street.
So he didn't need you?
He didn't need anybody. Grady promised him rave reviews for his next three shows if he shut this one down.
So he did tell you who's closing the show?
No!
Then how would you know the terms of a deal he made with Grady minutes before he died if you weren't the last person to see the line?
He laughed at me! No more shows, no more dreams. After all I had to take from him, he laughed at me and Elaine like we were nothing.
And?
I killed him.
Of course you did.
So what happens to me now, Lieutenant?
Well, on impulse, you lashed out at your unfaithful, blackmailing husband when he told you your daughter would never go to Broadway, which was something you'd sacrificed everything for. A decent lawyer might get you a few years on a reduced charge. Hey, a great lawyer might get you an all-expense-paid weekend in sunny San Diego. But you'll have to stand trial. Okay, listen, how about we build up your daughter's part some more, add another song or two for Nikki, and maybe I don't solve your part of the mystery until the show goes to Broadway.
You would do that? Oh, Frank, you give me that, and I'll let you walk me out of the cast party straight into police headquarters.
I'll have you watch day and night till then.
I understand. But if the show goes to New York, what about you and Nikki?
Well, I'm sure there's always a spot in the NYPD for a Boston police lieutenant who doesn't mind a cut in rank and pay.
You know what, Choffee? I think you're one of us.
There's a special kind of people known as Choffee. Sometimes we're not too certain what's false or what's real, but we're seldom in doubt about what we feel.
Lieutenant, you're experienced in assault and battery. I'm afraid Bobby might need some first aid. He's a bit wobbly on his feet after getting hit in the head by Grady.
Let me take a look at him.
We've only hours until the curtain opens, and I'm afraid he may not rise to the occasion.
Oh, don't worry, Chris. The sound of places everyone is like smelling salts to any trooper. The sound of the orchestra playing its overture will be pure adrenaline. His aches will be bathed in the spotlight. His spirits will be lifted by the hands of an adoring throng whose applause will sustain Bobby right to the very last scene of Robin in the Hood. How's this? Will you be my lawfully wedded wife, Miss Nikki? I mean, Nancy?
Yes!